Hi everybody. If you're watching this on YouTube, this is being recorded live over on Ustream TV. I've decided I'm going to try and do a regularly scheduled live stream every Monday at 1 Eastern. And I'm going to squeeze in between Dee Dee and Jean. So it's wall-to-wall streaming on Mondays. So anyway, I'm talking to people that are in a chat. I'm not sitting here talking to myself, which would be fine too. I'd have a lot of fun. Today does happen to be my birthday, so happy birthday to me. And all the fibs are being so nice, wishing me happy birthday, and they're always nice, but today they're indulging me, making me feel very special. So thank you very, very much. So today, I wasn't sure what I was going to do, and Lynn in Raleigh has asked a couple times that I do a stream on drawing flowers, which is, I don't know, it's almost overwhelming because it depends on what kind of flowers you want to draw. Because you can do doodle flowers, you can do Zentangle flowers, you can do realistic flowers, you can do botanically correct flowers. I mean, when you start talking flowers, that can be a lifetime of art, really. And there are people who dedicate their life to that. Look at George O'Keefe was a fabulous flower artist. Just there's so many. So anyway, I thought I'd start out like simple, like we'll do some doodle flowers and then we'll try and work up and maybe do not realistic, but you know, just more intricate, more involved. So Julie said, I like talking to myself, it's intelligent conversation. That's what I feel like too, Julie, that my conversations with myself are some of the best I've ever had. So, anyway, when I was getting prepared for this stream, sorry for the noise. I pulled out all my Zentangle cards that are flower related, and so I can show you some of those. And then just some different flowers. But when you, I wish Lynn was here. She hasn't come in yet that I can see. Geez, where'd that come from? Anyway, I collect doodles and I doodle all the time. So here's, let me get a white sheet of paper. Here's just some doodle. These are obviously Mary Englebright, flowers, that I like drawing. So I'm not real sure. What kind of flowers Lynn was talking about. They can be little tiny doodle flowers. What you prepare for streams? Oop, I knew I was doing something wrong. Well, yeah, while Dee Dee was streaming, I was yanking out stuff, you know. These are very Mary Englebrightish type flowers. And a lot of times I just like to draw, so I just, this is probably one of my favorite doodles that I do. If you look in my journals and stuff, this vine, I could draw that for you guys. That's so simple. But I use that a lot in my stuff. I think the rest of these pages now are all just quotes that I've collected up. Birthday stuff and yeah, just junk. Okay, here's a whole page of flowers. Holy cow. Just little doodle-type flowers. And I think we all do this, you know? You're gonna grow up to be like me now? Oh, jeez. I'm not sure that's a good idea, Judy. So, yeah. And also, in my preparation, Jean, believe it or not, I pulled out a bunch of books so that we could look at just books. I mean, and I have, let me see here, 15 books that I have on just flower drawing. And I'm not even real sure where to start, because it can be as simple as, okay, I pulled out a coloring book. I like this one. It's all real, and it's called Coloring Flowers, and I've got the camera a little close up, but I did that so that if I do draw, which I plan to, y'all can see what I'm doing. So anyway, this is just a coloring flower book. But the thing I liked about it is it gives you a color version of it down here, which I really liked. I mean, you can do it whatever color you want, but they're real simple line drawings of just flowers. And I have no clue where I got this. I don't know where I got this book, so don't ask. But if Trouble is here, she is awesome about getting the links in before I even know what I'm looking at. So, but these are, nobody has any books in their stash, Eileen, nobody. And I'm not suggesting you go out and buy all these books. I'm really not. I love Morning Glories. I love Morning Glories. And I plant and grow Morning Glories and Iris. But I love these line drawings. They're just so nice. Trouble is here. So chances are you guys in chat will get a link. Another type of iris. I love these. And look at the color depiction. I love that. So yeah, the cover of the book, please, is called Coloring Flowers, Over 40 Delightful Pictures with Full Coloring Guides. It's put out by Arcturus, A-R-C-T-U-R-U-S. Hi, Dee Dee. But yeah, do you want the ISBN number? I can put my glasses on and tell you. The ISBN is 978-1-4351-5635-7. So you can tell that I've really knocked it dead cleaning or coloring in this book. How's that light? Is that light better now that I turned on the Ott light? Way to go, me. Hey, Dee Dee, look. Happy birthday to me. Anyway, we'll just flip through here. Johnny Jump Ups, I think those are called. Wild Rose. I'm not sure what that is. Sweet Pea. Look, Trouble got it in there. You rock, Trouble. Here's a rose. I should know what that's called. I don't. I can draw flowers, but I can't name them. How about that? That's an orchid. That's pretty. I'm actually growing one of these, what are they called, like that Christmas flower thing. Ooh, look at that one. Look at the color on that one. That's really pretty. Someday I'm going to be able to color that good if I keep doing my color books. So anyway, that's just line drawings out of a coloring book. So there you go. I mean, if you want to practice drawing a flower, jump on that. All right. I'm going to try and not corner myself in today. Okay, so I'll do this one next. Lee Hammond is, her drawing instruction books have really helped me a lot. I like her, so I thought, okay, I'll get her book out. I have a bunch of her books, not necessarily all flowers. Okay, you guys have seen that. I drew that. If you saw my previous streams where I showed some of my artwork, I've already drawn that. Look at that. Well, thank you, Judy. I'm pretty sure not that great, but anyway. Hi, Laura. Thank you for the birthday wishes. I am having a very happy day so far. I've drawn this one. There's the finished product, and there it is in its early stages. And I'm a believer that given enough practice, we can all do this. And then I think in the beginning of this book, yeah, I've drawn this one, the rose. I was not happy with my version of this. This is an awesome book. Here's another step-by-step start with just a simple line drawing. And she did her line drawing in colored pencil. And that's a good thing because then you don't have to worry about erasing your sketch. And that's, you know, like Didi drawn in the light blue. She was using Colorase and Studio pencils for these. So she's not using any kind of special materials or anything, that's for sure. And then she gives you some graph drawings. So, yeah, if you want to learn to draw something like that, there you go. It's a very simple line drawing with a graph. And this one is called Flowers in Nature, Drawing in Color by Lee Hammond. And Lee Hammond has books out, and I'm not doing a commercial for her, and she doesn't pay me. But she does people and pets and flowers and just everyday things that people want to draw. And then she taught, you know, like you get a lesson in hard shadows and, yeah, shading. And this is a pretty good beginner's book if you're interested in learning this. Okay, on this one she said to get this fuzzy looking peach, and I'm sorry for the glare. Lighting is always an issue. She used Verathin pencils, and Verathin is in the Prismacolor line, and they're hard lead. So they don't behave anywhere like the Prismacolor Premier that Didi and I use. This is drawn with Prismacolor. And then this one is drawn with watercolor pencils. So see how different they can look given the mediums that you choose to work with. And I think we all have our favorites. I like colored pencil. And so a lot of these books that I have are geared toward colored pencil art because that's what I enjoy doing. I enjoy graphite and colored pencil. And here's flowers and colored pencils. You can get this at, or you used to be able to. I don't know if you can anymore. But this is at Hobby Lobby, Michaels, any of them. And again, it's just, it's eye candy. But it also shows you, you know, how they go about it, what colors they do first. My guess is they're using Prismacolor. All right. Yeah, they talk about a lot of different kinds of pencils and whether they're oil-based or wax-based. They talk about polychromos, Caran d'Ache, water-soluble. So, yeah, you usually always get an introduction to materials at the beginning of the books. So, there you go. But they give you the line drawings to start with. And look at that. That's so pretty. Who wouldn't want to be able to do that with your own hands? Just eye candy. And one of the nice things is it, you know, if you feel like you can't draw, having that color book and practicing to try and just get the colors accurate and the shading and choice of colors. I'm getting better. But when I started, I mean, I asked Dee Dee some of the most idiotic questions about how she goes about choosing color. It's really just seeing with your eyes. It really is. That's what I've decided. Hi, Carol Renee. Look at that. Ugh. So pretty. Petunias. And look at how the light is bouncing off them. Not the light, my light, but just how the artist has shown the light in the pictures, in the darks. It's so awesome. Beautiful rose. I think this is what maybe Dorothy was wanting the other night when I was doing the watercolor thing where Eileen was bossing me around. Mine didn't look this good. I'm going to see. Hang on. Yeah. I got a long way to go. There's my flower. There's a real artist flower. All I've learned from that is you need to practice, girl. But I haven't worked on this anymore since the other night. I've been doing other stuff. None of it artistic, believe me. But my carpets are clean. God, that's beautiful. But this is a really inexpensive little book. I mean, but they're saying $9.95 in the U.S. And then if you use your coupon on it, you can get that for, what, $5? $5-6? And there's a lot of valuable information. You'll learn a lot. I mean, you could stay busy in this one book if you did all the flowers and really worked at it. This would keep you busy an entire month. Easy. So if you do all my books times a month, I'm going to die and never finish. All right, I picked this one up. I don't know if there's any flowers. Okay, you guys have seen this drawing. I've done this one. Thank you, Dee Dee. It needs some work, but I'm a work in progress, so it's okay. Yeah, there's nothing in that one. All right, this one is Draw Flowers Using Pencils, Pastels, Crayons, and Charcoal by Ann Piper, I guess. It's put out by Search Press. And I haven't looked through these too much. I mean, I really went in the bookshelf and just started yanking out flowers. So, to kind of show you guys, really. But these are all just line drawings. We could do this. Judy, I'm right there with you. That I've drawn an awful lot with graphite. I'm trying to learn and introduce color. And it's a learning curve just like anything else. But see here how they've given you an idea of getting the basic shape of the tulip. And then that's actually a photograph, I think. I don't think. No, that's a photograph. But just drawing what you see. And I think a lot of it's just training your brain to really draw what you see. Okay, question. Chat does go fast when you're streaming, so if I don't answer your question, ask it again. What pencil do I consider the lightest one to use when you erase, and the eraser will erase easily? I don't know. I tend to stay right about with a number 2, an HB. if you get too much into the bees, they get harder and harder to erase. But if you get too much in the H scale, what I found is I press harder and I leave an impression in my paper. And I think that's one thing you've got to watch out for if you're doing a line drawing to color in later, is don't press when you're doing your sketch, because you don't want to impress the paper, because you can't get that back out. Hi, Orla. Okay, you can get some of these books on Amazon used from 68 cents plus shipping. And most of those places are $3.99 shipping. I know, because I've ordered from them. So anyway, that's the one thing. I hope I answered your question, but really, I don't think you need any special tools to draw. Walk into Walmart, buy yourself a pack of mechanical pencils or a number two pencil with an eraser, and go for it. One thing I do agree with Edie on is get a white eraser. Don't use a pink eraser. Get a white eraser that's not going to leave a mark when you're done. I mean, you don't want to fight your tools. And I just got this, hang on, it's dusty. I'm going to... Prismacolor Scholar Eraser. I haven't used it yet. I just got it. I'm eager to see how it does, and it's black. But if it leaves a black mark, it'll go in the trash. I won't use it. Okay, you're using an F. See, I don't even know where you're from, Barb, but generally pencils here are rated H to B, somewhere in between a real hard lead or a real soft lead. And I use somewhere in the middle of the scale. If I was using, okay, Judy is saying F is a really hard lead. What I would find is it's not so much that it's hard to erase, but that you've pressed harder and left an imprint in your paper. Now, there are times when pressing hard and leaving that imprint to color over is a good thing. But that's a technique, not necessarily what you want to do when you're drawing. And see how the line drawing here is just so easy. So I hope I answered your question. But I think everybody wants to learn to draw a rose because they're gorgeous. If they could only have the same smell. But I mean, if you want to draw a simple rose, I mean, and this is a doodle I do all the time. Something as simple as this. That's why I'm saying, you know, it depends on what kind of drawing you want to do. But there you go. There's the simplest rose on earth. Another doodle. Rose that's really easy is draw a circle. Just start with a little circle. Doesn't have to be perfect. And just start drawing petals around it. But keep in mind, this is just coming out of my head. This isn't, it's not going to look like a real rose anywhere. But there you go. There's your rose. And then I could color that so that it really looks like a rose. Go ahead and give it a stem and five leaves, because roses, well, they have three or five leaves. But there you go. I mean, that's about as simple a rose as you can draw. So that's why I'm saying, I mean, when you talk about drawing, are we talking just doodle-ish flowers? Here's a Mary Englebright. Well, I don't know if it's a rose, but she does a flower much like this that, to me, always looks like a rose. And then she gives it the leaves like this. I mean, it doesn't get any simpler than that. Don't you love the pencil? Dee Dee turned us all on to these Graph Gear 1000. Oh, and I have one coming for my birthday. I have the 5 and the 7. The 5 I keep blue lead in, but I went ahead and ordered the 03 too, because I should have it. I thought. Yeah. Pink erasers do leave a stain, so you don't want to do that. Get yourself just a plastic white eraser. You can get these anywhere. And then there's another one. This magic rub. You can buy these by the box. Because not only can you use them for erasers, but you can carve into them and make your own rubber stamps out of these. And eventually they harden, but they last for a long, long time. And they're cheap, cheap, cheap. So, but this is actually for big areas. This is my favorite eraser. Zentangle will help with other forms of art. I believe that too, Janice. Hi, by the way. And see, Josie? I have a good reason. I should have it. And I think they make a lot of different other weights. Is that what you were looking for? You are a knucklehead. Robert Vaughn just came in. He's looking for his sunglasses, and they're on the top of his head. And I wonder about him. I worry about him a lot. Anyway, that's the eraser talk. So here we go. Yeah, if you hang around long enough, you collect up a lot of erasers. But another one that I love, I'm getting nervous. My little Mono Zero eraser has disappeared. Oh, I may have to order a case of those bad boys. Really, now I'm scared. I'm nervous. I wonder if it's out at the couch. Anyway, I won't take up any of your time worrying about it today. But anyway, so really, there's a rose leaf. Drawing on textured paper, that's very cool. I like that. And here's just basic shapes. I mean, it doesn't get any simpler than that, you guys. It really doesn't. I mean, we can do that. We're going to do that like in 2 seconds, real quick, okay? And I'm just using, this is the Canson cold press paper that was laying here from the other night. All right, here we go. We're going to do this one because it doesn't get any simpler than that. I'm going to draw a circle. Circle inside the circle. And 5 lines up. Now, just draw the shapes. And I sketch like this. A lot. And kind of, you know, watch your lines, your guidelines. That's why they're there. But it doesn't have to be identical. Try and keep your, I'm going to adjust this one because I don't like it. Now when you get the basic idea of what you like, make your adjustments as you go. I may be sorry I use this paper, but And not all the petals are going to be the same shape. They're just not. And then I think for realism, try and get them to overlap, because flower petals always overlap. There you go, basic flower. And it's an odd shape, no doubt about it. And at this point, I would go ahead and take my pen. And ink it. And what I ink is not going to be the exact same as my sketch. I'm going to make my corrections as I go. And this is, believe me, quick and dirty. I'm going to give that a second to dry. But that's how quick it is, guys. It's not hard at all. You love your mono eraser? I know, I do too. I'm going to have to find it. It's probably out in my art bag on the couch, really, because I was drawn last night out there. All right. Get out my magic rub. Get rid of my pencil. Now, if I color that in, give it a little dimension. Draw in some leaves. You could add that pup on a card and send it to your mother for her birthday. But see how easy it is? I think most people let themselves get really intimidated by something that can be very, very simple. Very, very simple. You wish you were quick and dirty? Well, I think when you're sketching, It's good to go fast. Don't give your brain a chance to undermine you. Like, just do it. Twigs. I like that. There's the name of them. I need to remember that. Now here's some color. But look how simple the drawings are. And one thing I wish you guys would quit doing is quit telling yourself you can't do it. You can. Anybody can make that mark on paper. Anybody. Don't reinforce that, oh, I can't do it, I can't do it. You do it enough times, you will do it, I promise you. Look at how simple that is. You can do that. And that's getting more involved, but it still is just a line at a time. And you have an eraser. And I think if you start out easy and then add more detail as you go, you're not going to do that the first day you start out. You're not. But if you'd got a reasonable facsimile the first time, the next time you could add more detail. And see what you did wrong and try again. Look at that. Adding the shadows. That's with graphite. That doesn't intimidate me. Making me look yellow, that intimidates me. But I'm willing to try and I will keep trying until someday I can show you a piece of art and go, oh wow, I'm so proud of myself. Oh, that has phone numbers on it. Probably don't want to put that out there for the world. Calla lilies. I love calla lilies. See, Barb? There you go. Testament, right? In chat. How to start. Make it better. Until eventually you end up with something that looks like what you're trying to draw. That one's a neat one. Step by step drawing. And see, it's got a good dimension on it, because, you know, flowers are funny. You never see them, you know, like I drew it like that, but that's rare to see a flower. There'd be something up covering part of it, or you see the back side of it. I like that. I like all of them. Who am I lying to? But I don't know, I think this, for just to get you started and make you feel confident that you can do what you want to do, this is a pretty good book. Draw Flowers. And I'm sure Trouble already got the link in there for you. And I like this one. Look how fun this is. A dandelion with its little seeds flying all over. Hi, Scooby. Thank you for the birthday wishes. She's eating lunch with us. Yeah, I like that. That's really cool. And that's, I mean, nothing more than some lines. Like, really, this is, doesn't get any simpler than that. Right? And that, he was using chalk on that. And chalk is that's a nice product to use for that. Chalk on blue paper. Now I want to try that. I want to get out my stuff and try that. That's graphite. I love that. Flower doodles on your book list. Yep. I do it all the time. Doodle flowers. I thought today I'd just show you some of these Zentangle ones, because Laura wanted Zentangle and Lynn wanted drawing flowers. So that's a beautiful tulip. You can draw. You can do it. Anyway, this has taken a long time. Sorry. I get into books and I could be here the rest of the day. Here's another one, drawing flowers. I think this one is, yeah, this is all graphite. I use the heck out of this book. Step-by-step guide. And I'll show you the these are all graphite, but look at how pretty they are. The color ones are gorgeous, but you can do just as good in black and white. Dandelions are what you call them. Yeah, dandelions. Okay, you guys, one thing I'm going to caution you to is you don't have to go out and buy all these books today. Make a list and get yourself one that you think is the best. Draw in it for a few days. See if it's something you really enjoy before you just go out and buy a bunch. I have used, look at this one. Look at all the bookmarks in this one. I have used these books, used them. And they're all pretty simple. Step out, and then they give you the color, the black and white version, and the color version at the end. But I honestly, I don't think you need all these. I'm just self-indulgent. But they're all just pretty basic line drawings. Show you how to step it out, and then ultimately give you the color version. That's why I'm cautioning you. I'm the same way. You know, my wish list, if I went out and just bought everything that I saw that I wanted, would at some point be about 10 grand. Well, honestly, do I need all these books on drawing flowers? I must, because I have them. All right, I'm going to... Oh, this one I got out just because this is pretty eye candy. But I bought this one day because Dee showed it on stream, and I love this. And it's not necessarily a how-to book, but I love the writing in it, I like the art in it. It's the kind of journal I wish I had, where I wrote and drew beautiful flowers and did some illumination art, and I like the way this looks, and I like her handwriting, and yeah. And this woman has several of these books. I bought this one. So, anyway, yeah. This was a DD-enabled book, but I'm not even the least bit sorry that I did it. But I'll show you the kind of art I really love. The Art of Botanical Illustration. And I've had this book, and it sits on my table where I sit all the time. And again, I have Buku bookmarks, either something I'm going to try to draw, something I've already drawn. Let's just flip to one and see why I have it. There's something either in the narrative or something that I wanted to go back and read or look at. But this is the type of artwork that, oh, look at this one. This one is awesome. I would love to do that someday. You know what? Uli, I'm going to call you Uli. I think when it comes to books and pencils and pens and supplies, I would probably give Dee Dee a run for her money, and I think we probably have pretty much exactly the same. I think she's just far more versatile than I am. Oh, look at this one. And this is what I like when they show you the flower in full bloom. That's gorgeous. And then they have a little like a seed pod drawing down there. I just love that kind of art. That was done in 1743. So people have been doing this an entire lifetime. Look at this one. That one I could cut out and frame. But I'd be happier if I did that myself. Oh, I didn't have that one bookmarked or something. But anyway, yeah, there are just some gorgeous pieces of art in here. That's an opium poppy. And then look at this double page spread. And I'm not sure what mediums they were using, but I mean, these were done. They're probably paints of some kind. But anyway, the whole book is just full of art, and it's a history of the classic illustrators and their achievements. Yeah, they do look like old-fashioned wallpaper panels for sure. But yeah, this is one of my very favorite books that I own. And I think there's another one upstairs that I didn't go up and get. So anyway, there's still more books here, but one thing I would say is if you're gonna, if you want to draw realistic, get yourself a reference. You know, and Dee Dee said it 100 times, and I think anybody who arts and draws will tell you, you're not going to remember what stuff looks like. You're not going to be able to remember the shadows and how the petals overlap one another. And see how the cast shadow that's thrown here from that petal above it? If you don't draw that accurately, you're not going to know that that petal's even there. The only way you know is there is a line, but the line is there because the shadow's underneath it. Poor Janet knew that flower name real fast. Okay, Eileen, I cheated. It was on the page. You think I go around looking for opium flowers? I would if they grew in Oklahoma, but yeah. But yeah, and I have this book. But I would say don't go out and buy one. Get on the computer. I mean, do Google images and you can come up with this many and 5 million more. But because I draw when we travel a lot and I don't know when I'm going to have internet or when I'm not, yeah, I take my reference photos with me. Look at that. Somebody drew that. That's gorgeous. I love sunflowers too. So anyway, yeah, get yourself a reference. But if you want to just draw doodly flowers. That's fun too. And I just got this one out because it's colored pencil art, and if you've not seen it, it's so cool a book. Is that not cool? Now these are some uber talented people here. Look at that. And one of the reasons I bought this is because, oh, look at Jax. I did black and white version of Jax. Jigsaw puzzle of flowers. That is a cool idea. I like that. But let me see. There's one in here. I'll show it to you. I'll try and find it. Here's a bunch of flowers. Trying to keep the glare from killing you guys. Easier still, just draw a flower and not a picture of one. Yeah. All right, where's the thing I wanted to show you that I love so much? But there's every kind of art in here. Landscape, people, flowers, on different papers where you can see if you draw on a paper with, look at those geese, with a lot of texture, your drawing is going to have a lot of texture. So you got to think about that when you start out. I love this clown's hair. Sorry, Carrie. If you're looking, Carrie, I'm sorry. Look at the tropical fish. Which this is not getting me any closer to drawing flowers. Oh, look at. Okay. That's my man right there. I love me some Rod. He actually sang my theme song, which is Forever Young, which is kind of a play on words, since my name is Young, and it will always be Young. Look at the black and white. Now, I like graphite, but I'm not that good. But I'm practicing to be that good someday, and here's the people. I admire people who can do this so much. But they put in their time. It didn't happen overnight. I did a pinwheel. Mine doesn't look like that. Look at that flower. And look at the water drops on it. I love that. And I said I'll show you how to draw water drops someday. Abstract. Snow leopard. There's my brother. Yep. Hi, CB. Well, I must have flipped right by, unless it's still up here. Look at the colors on this one. How beautiful is that? Oh, you've been here from the start and just got chat. Wow. I don't know what's going on with Ustream. It's free. Thank you. And these, I don't know if they're Bess Borgeson, but they sure look like hers. And I like this. I like that. Well, I flipped past it. I'm not going to go back and find it. What the heck? Want some spaghetti? I like that one because I like the checkerboard background. That's just fun and whimsical. Look at those little guys. Oh, he's showing you his bottom. All right, I flipped past it. Oh, well, who cares? So anyway, So I don't know. Maybe Lynn is still having trouble getting into chat. Yeah, Lynn's still not here, so I guess she'll have to catch it on recording. So anyway, I'm gonna grab me a piece of paper. Okay, here's the one from the other night. This is that mixed media, Canson mixed media paper. I'll show you some of the yeah, free but a pain in the whatever. Gonna flip through the Zentangle patterns. Now these, I'm sure I got most of them at zentanglepatterns.com. You've had to reboot chat a few times too, so I'm sorry it's being a pain for you guys. I know sometimes at DeeDee's I get so frustrated because I want to hear and I want to be there, and it's just like, oh, you stream. Okay, we drew this one the other night, Art Flower. That one can be very fun. Obviously, vastly different than the realistic flowers that we just were looking at. This one I like a lot, Buttercup. And that's simple. I mean, that literally is. I'm going to get this doodle sheet back over here. Circle in the middle. I mean, four leaves like that. And if you do a whole page of them. Which book, Lulu? The last one I showed? This one is just, this last book that I showed is the best of colored pencil. It's not a how-to book. There's nothing in there other than people's colored pencil art. And it's put out by the Colored Pencil Society of America, which I'm not a member of. I just bought their book. But look at how those pinwheels are so fun. That is a great website for tangles. So, yeah. But if you just want to look at other people's art, and I have several of these artists, you know, several of the people that are shown in this book have put out their own books, and I buy them as well. I like supporting artists. I mean, it's a tough way to make a living. Not that I've ever done it, believe me, but yeah. I don't know what I did with. Oh, there they are. So there you go. How simple is that? You're almost done with your sketchbook thanks to Tangles. Well, I think it's a good way to build up confidence, and there's Cosmic Flower. Anybody can do that. It's simple. Here's the dandelion, like that one I was showing you. That is a cool tangle. That one's neat. See how it looks very involved, but when you break it down into its individual steps, simple stuff. I don't love that one, but I guess if you put it all the way around a border, it could look very cool. Flower vine, I like that. And that, I mean, you can do that. I like that one. This is one of my very favorites. And that is so simple. Island flower. That one could be very pretty. There's a little rose. Now that's simple too. You could do that. Rosettes. and their little buds. Excuse me. Too much coffee this morning. I think I'll have a sip. Eileen gets too tangled to do any tangles. Oh, I guess I pulled this one for the so flowers, which is kind of like that other one I showed you. This one here with a little bit different spin on it. Robert's got 1 hour and he better be home, because if I have to deal with that mess, heads are going to roll. That one's pretty. That would be an awesome border. Thanks for putting in the link, CB. Yeah, you love henna drum too. I do too. Links are open. Yes, CB, it showed up just fine. Here's Schmoozy. I don't know why it got the name Schmoozy, but that looks kind of like, what do you call that? Coneflower. Bye, Scooby. Have a great day, and thank you so much for the birthday wishes. I'm having a fun day hanging out with you guys. I can't imagine what I'd rather do on my birthday than hang with you guys. Jeez, that... I guess to get them straight for you guys, I have to hold them sideways or something. I don't know. My camera's really goofed up. That one's very nice, and it looks very involved, and it's not. There's a Zen bud. Rose in a heart. And then this one we drew the other night. A zinger. It's not exactly a flower, but I love that one. So, there you go. Those are all the Zentangle flowers patterns, at least that I had in my book. So I'm not sure what kind of flowers you guys want me to draw. I guess I could just doodle like I can sit and doodle flowers all day long. This is one of my favorites. Oops, goofed up already. And where's my Mono Zero eraser? But this can be really pretty if you add color to it. And I've shown you that one. Here's another Mary Angle Bright Flower. It doesn't get any more simple than this if you're doodling either. Draw a circle around the circle, and some leaves. The woman got famous doing that. Made mega bucks. Mega, mega bucks. So I'm not sure if you want me to grab one of these books and draw a flower out of it. Just do the doodle flowers. And Lynn wanted me to go look up, I guess, Christy Sablowski or whatever draws her own kind of flower. And she wanted me to go look at that and then show a step out of it. I did not get a chance to do that, so I'm sorry, Lynn, but I will at some point. Let me look in my little book here. Okay, I think I did all that. I'm trying to think. I'm going to look at something real quick here. All right, I'm not finding it. Well, here's one version of it. All right. All right, I'm just going to draw you quickly a version of that flower that I draw a lot. And I've used it on birthday cards and just start out with a simple circle. And if I wanted that perfect, I would use a template. And then I draw it where it doesn't touch. And it doesn't have to be perfect. All right, now I'm going to, I was going to do one thing and I just thought, well, maybe I'll do something different. That's the ink on that. This ink does become permanent, but it's got to dry for a while. And so I guess when I'm doing this, I should be using one of these other pens that dries quicker, because that one's got to be absorbed. But anyway, I'll quickly do it with, I'll color it in with Neo Color 2s for you guys. In my tray. Look at, I know, Dee Dee. I mistreat them, don't I? Badly mistreated art supplies. They haven't run away yet, so we're good. Oh, there it is. There's the one I'm looking for. I take the color off the unsharpened end. And the black may run a little bit, and I'm not going to worry about it. Oops, cat hair on the paintbrush, bad thing. There's cat hair everywhere. That cat of mine. For the amount of hair I clean up around this house, you'd think I have 4 cats. Dang it. Eileen, I knew you wanted me to use pink. Oops, outside the lines. Going quiet. Can't talk, Artin. And I know that looks ridiculous. Painting myself in a corner here. This is commonly how I entertain myself. Just draw some doodle, paint it in with my fun art supplies that you guys have encouraged me to buy, Eileen. And my nose is running again today. I think I do have allergies. I must. And I don't know if you guys have seen enough of my art by now to know that I like nice, bright colors. I know Dee Dee loves earth tones, and Eileen and Jean like all shades of green. I like any bright color at all. And I'm just doing this on cheap paper, so the paper will buckle and it'll get crinkly, and I don't care. Eileen wants to see me draw a pink flamingo. You know what? I don't want her to know it, but I really like her, and I want her to come back to my stream, so I probably won't be drawing a flamingo. Allergic to streaming. No, I really wonder if I'm not allergic to the, I don't know, whatever the leaves throw off when they're falling all over, the mold or whatever. I could be allergic to that damn cat. I almost got out the ink tents, CB. That's when I was kind of hesitant a minute ago. I thought, oh, I could get out my ink tents blocks because I don't use them as much as I use the Neos, but yeah. But here in just a minute, I'm going to get out the Prismacolor. Okay, I'm going to do, let's see, what do I want to do? I want a light blue background. Here, I like this blue a lot. And this is just a quick thing to show you guys how you can make something so pretty quickly with no training. Believe me, I've had no training. Some people would say you ought to get house trained, but my nose is bothering me today. I mean, I'm going quick now. And tomorrow my new brushes come and my new pens and my new O3 Graph Gear pencil. Sorry, I'm getting off screen, you guys. I'm such a dope. And I don't care if this background is even or not. I don't care at all. Because when it's done, it'll be pretty, I hope. If it's not, it's paper. I'll throw it away. If it comes out good, I'll cut it out, put it in my journal. I'll slap it on an envelope for Happy Mail. Who knows? Oh, I'll show you another quick, well, that vine thing that I draw a lot. I love it. Because, you know, like Carrie and different people have shown how I decorate envelopes. This is how I would decorate an envelope. Just something real quick and dirty. No big deal. Just get her done. All right, I'm going to dry that real quick. Hang on. I hope it didn't get unplugged. I'll bet it did. Nope. All right. Keep going. Yeah, baby, I'm going to take it. I ordered for myself the Graph Gear in 03. So when I do really small writing, I have a pencil. I didn't need it, believe me. Exactly, to be stronger, more intense colors. That's funny. We're teasing Eileen. Alright, that's probably dry enough. I'm going to get out. Now, at this point, I would either use ink or colored pencils. I'm just going to get out the colored pencils, and I have no place to put them, so bear with me. If you guys saw this little space that I have this set up in, you would be laughing your head off. Let's see, I want Copenhagen, and it's probably small because I use it all the time. And just a pretty green. Lots of pretty greens. But I want a dark one. I'll use peacock. What the heck? And then that one just to blend it. And I got the pink and the blue. Oh, I need a little bit of an orange. I'll use this one and real orange. All right. Those are the colors we're going to use to finish this off. Hey, Jean. Eileen wants to know if you're awake. She probably has a question that she wants to ask you. Okay, now we're just gonna doodle this up and make it real pretty. And I might need a sharpener, and I should have gotten my good one out of my case, but I didn't, so I'll use this. That was the phone number one. I like my pencils kind of sharp. And I've shown this before, but I'm going to show it again. When my pencils get small, like this one's getting too small for me to enjoy using, I'll use a pencil extender on it for a little while, but then I eventually end up gluing it to the replacement pencil, and then I use all my pencil. And I've shown that before. Not rocket science, but see, this one's been glued on. And you can sure tell when you're, like this pencil, and it's not the sharpener. It sharpened this one perfectly. This one, how the wood, you can just tell from the wood that it's crappy quality. Look at all my pencils have been glued on. All right, we got sharp pencils. That makes us happy girls. What glue do I glue it on with? Whatever's right at my elbow, I don't care. I can use Aline's Tacky. If I have E6000, I'll use it. It doesn't matter to me. I'll use anything. One thing I would say, though, when you glue it on, and see this one, the reason it has two ends is because my granddaughter was using these pencils, and so this would normally, I would glue this onto this end, okay? I wouldn't glue it on to this end, because I like when my numbers and the names of the pencils, let's see if I've got one that's a good example. Probably not, because my granddaughter sharpened a bunch of them on the wrong end. But anyway, I would glue it to this end of the pencil rather than this end, like I'm showing it here. But anyway, yeah, I just, okay, and if this was a real piece of art that I, it will sharpen through the glue, but as soon as I get to that glue, thing, especially on this, if it was on this end, I'd just keep on sharpening it. But on this end, when I get into that glue, then I break it off and go use this end. So I always have my number and name on them. I like them on there. Anyway, it does sharpen through the glue. Like on these, I don't know. I would bet that I used Aline's Tacky Glue. And then I just hold it on there, and I might washi tape it for a day or two until it's good and dry. That's all I do. I haven't had any problem with them falling off. Just experiment with different kinds of glue that you've got. Don't go out and buy anything special, believe me. It's just glue. Okay, so now I'm going to create some little shadow and then blend it out. Okay. I don't like crumbs on my art, and I have a brush. I'll show you. I have multiple kinds here. I have the Draftsman Duster Brush, but I don't like this one as well. So I have a couple of these. Like, I'll use this one, and then in my pencil case, I have to get out a pencil extender anyway, so bear with me. I keep this one to brush off. And the reason I do that is because those little crumbs, if you brush them with your hand, will write on the paper. And you don't want them writing on the paper. If it's good art. Something like this, I don't care about. I mean, if I get a little mark on the paper, I don't care. We're not talking fine art here. Right? Okay, pencil extender. And I'm sure you guys have seen these. They're not anything special. You can get them at Hobby Lobby or anywhere, really. My favorite ones, actually, I got at the art store. This is not one of them. Push that up, and it prolongs the life of your pencils. Hi, Lynn. You finally showed up after I've been doing this for hours and you wanted this. I hope you didn't have trouble getting in with chat. Anyway, yeah, Jean must be snoozing really, really good. All right, so when I'm doing doodly art like this, I do like the outlines around the flowers just to add more color and make it prettier. And I can sure tell that I've had about 15, 20 cups of coffee this morning. I'm jittery. And I'm just showing you this because it's something you can do really simple on envelopes or whatever. This flower is my own. I'm sure I'm not the first person in the history of the world, but this one I call it my own. Oops. See? I'm throwing stuff. So did Jean. Oh, Jean did show up. Hi, Jean. Did you have a good nap? And then I just softened the edges of what I outlined. Just color over it a little bit. But you could do the whole thing with colored pencil and then not have to go through this step. I just do it. I hope you guys can see. I'm trying to kind of keep my hands where I'm not blocking your view, you know what I mean, Jelly Bean? Did you guys hear my stomach growl? Oh my gosh. I have not eaten today. And we didn't have cake at coffee. They should have had cake for my birthday, right? It's all right. We had cake last week. Now I'm just smearing that around a little bit. Take away the harsh edges. Sometimes I get them too sharp and I have to break that little point off so it doesn't leave a mark where it breaks on the paper. Oh, I didn't get out a light blue. Dodo. So, Jean, what are you doing on today's stream? You do your Nano Jumo or whatever that's called? Do we need to think up a song title? Where are we going for dinner for my birthday? I don't know. We haven't really talked about it. Bye, Carol Renee. Sorry if you're already gone. I don't know. Tonight, we have a little Mexican restaurant just down the road, and if I don't feel like cooking when it gets a little bit later, I'll just say let's just run down there. But tomorrow, we're going into Joplin because I've got company coming, so I got to go get a bunch of groceries, and yeah, I got a bunch of stuff to do. And I want to go to Longhorn Steakhouse and get a filet. That's my favorite dinner. Either that or tomorrow night we could also go to depends on what time we're done shopping. There's a casino on the way home, and we don't gamble, but they have an all-you-can-eat crab leg night, and that is really my ultimate favorite food. So we'll just see what tomorrow holds, but I think that's currently our plan. Is that we're going to go to Joplin and shop, get groceries for company. I might drop into Michael's or Tuesday morning and buy myself another birthday present if I want. And, yeah, eat out. Tomorrow really will be more my birthday. And I didn't ask Robert for anything. I just said, let's just go to dinner. And he said he would pay my Amazon bill if I wanted. No cooking on your birthday. I kind of agree. But, you know, it depends on what happens this afternoon. In my life, I pretty much have to play it by ear. So, yeah. But if I cook today, it's going to be something simple. Believe me, we might get hamburgers. Just something I can get done pronto. And quite frankly, like a birthday is just another day for me. Robert hounds me like, what do you want for your birthday? What do you want for your birthday? You know what? It's just another day. This one's a big one because I'm just damn old now, but I don't care. He doesn't have to do anything special. I told him he didn't even have to buy me a card this year. I said, I don't even care. Don't even buy me a card. I don't care. But that bothered him, not doing it. So I don't know which blue I want, so I'm using that one. Oh, I love my Prismacolor pencils. Every time I open it, it just makes my heart feel good. Let me see if I can show you. Okay, I'm going to show you guys. When you glue your pencils together, you can honestly end up with nubs that look like this. See that little thing? Is that not cute? But yeah, I have fewer of these now that I glue them. I used to have tons and tons of them. Yeah, we don't exchange gifts. I mean, we're kind of at a place in our life where if we want something, I'm not waiting until my birthday. I'm going to buy it and be done with it. That's it. I'm not waiting for my birthday. Or Christmas. Or Valentine's. I know, itty bitty pencils. Okay, now I'm going to smooth out these edges a little bit, just so they're not so harsh. Okay, so if you, like, I'm just going to say, if you were doing like an envelope and you had these on there, one of the things I do to kind of tie it all together, and I'm sure some of you who have gotten my Happy Mail have seen this. Take me just a second to show you. Hang on. Don't give up on me now. But see that, like where I brushed the pink, there's little pink marks now on there. So if this was like a really good piece of art or something I was going to show to somebody, that would bother me. But it doesn't bother me on this. So that's why you keep your trusty paintbrush around. See? I should be going like this. But see how much more pretty it is now that I've got a little bit of color on it? It doesn't even begin to resemble that ugly thing I originally drew. But then if I this was an envelope and I had several of these spread out, whatever. But then to tie it all together, what I would do is, I've shown you guys, I'll show you with this one because you can make one of these easy. You know those cutting mats that you can get at the Dollar Tree, maybe for $1. You can cut yourself one of these. But what I would do is use this as a template. You can use a ruler, whatever. I'm going to use a pen on this. Hopefully this will work. But I would take just any old stupid pen. And by doing this in the background, it kind of pulls it all together so that you, like, they're not just pieces of art hanging out there, which is fine too. But this kind of yanks it all together and makes it look really pretty. Now I dropped it on the floor. You know what? On Mondays, I'm going to have to curtail my coffee drinking because I'm throwing stuff. And all I use this for, honestly, is just a spacer. And these lines would go however long the piece of art was. And if you're on an envelope, go corner to corner, whatever. But this is the sort of thing, how to finish things, that I think a lot of people who are new to card making or crafting or whatever don't think to do. Is you do the little extra that kind of yanks it all together and makes it look finished. Kind of like putting a background around a portrait. You know, it's not just a face hanging in space. It's, you've grounded it. I don't know. It makes it look finished, believe me. Okay, and then that, for example, if you had a whole page of those, would be fine. But if you wanted to finish it more, go ahead and draw some circles where the joints are. just makes it look that much more detailed. Can't hurt nothing, right? Just makes it look a little bit more finished. Another thing I do a lot of times, if I do the lines like this, to make it look finished. And I don't care if they're square or whatever, it doesn't matter to me. I do try and make them evenly spaced. I mean, that makes sense, but I don't care if it's a perfect square. It's not even necessarily with the same color. Pick another color. And by the way, I love these Papermate pens. Love the Papermates. Just draw dots in the corners. Just little things like that make a big difference in your finished product. You can't hardly see that. But just something as simple as that makes it makes it just look that much more finished. So now that I've finished this, I mean, I'm not finished, but I might go back in and put some more Neo in the background or whatever. But if you did a border of these, whatever. Hey, Lynn, now that you're here, because I didn't know what kind of flower drawing you wanted me to do. So, yeah, just simple as that. And different products are obviously going to look different. You can get a more vibrant pink. If I wanted more vibrant pink, I maybe would add some of this Papermate. Who knows? Just experiment. I might add some more water to this now that I've added the Papermate, because the Papermate with water now. And I always wipe the wax off the tips of my pens. Try and get the Papermate to move a little bit. I a lot of times will use like felt tip pens or markers, like watercolor. Move them around. Just whatever you want, because you are the boss, man. I could sit and just dink around all day. So now I have to take a break, read chat. Thanks, you guys. They like this idea. So that flower I sent you. Oh, you know what, Lynn? I have not had a chance. I'm sorry. I've been really having crazy days here. I have not had a chance to go and look at Christy's flower, but I will. She got old today, Lynn. She won't remember. Eileen, honestly, you have no idea. You say you don't need a bullet journal and you don't need a planner and you don't need to write things down. Let me tell you, in my world, I have to write everything down. Everything. Like grocery lists. If I go to the Walmart without a grocery list, I don't have something written down, I'm going to come home with a bag of Cheetos and jelly beans. I mean, that's how bad I am. I'd forget the milk, the bread, the things that I went for. I mean, I have to have everything written down. I'm a lame brain. I was going to show you another thing. I'll just use these because they're close at hand, but I could use some colored pencil or anything. Another thing I love, and I use it a lot, is I'll start down here. I do this on envelopes when I have no time, and now I've got people expecting some sort of decoration on envelopes. Oh, I know one thing that you guys will all have. You may not have the Papermates, but I know one thing you'll all have because Dee Dee told you to buy it, and I'm sure you did. And I'm not sure that I've got a real great set anymore, but we'll see if this one will work good. The Crayola Marker Super Tips makes this little project go really, really fast. You're like that and you're in your 40s. I was like, yeah, I don't even make excuses for myself. I have a bad memory. I don't remember stuff. But the thing is, if I write it down, I'll never forget it. Anyway, make yourself just a curlicue border and draw random leaves. And we're going to make a vine of flowers. This is the simplest thing in the world. Anybody can do it. And it makes your envelopes and stuff really, really pretty. And it makes you feel like you're an artist. And you don't have to use mine. Make up your own. And if you use mine, I don't care either. If you sell it, give me credit and send me a check. There you go. I like that idea. Checks coming in the mail. Ah, that's what I wish I had. I mean, look how fast this is. I love these Crayola tip markers, and I've used them for years. I don't like the centered ones, though. The scent gives me a headache. See where we're going with this? And Eileen is loving it because of all the green leaves here. Eileen, are the rooms in your house all painted green? They probably are, because my favorite color is navy blue, and the room I'm sitting in right now has navy blue walls, and it's just my favorite. You can't help but be happy when you come in here. Navy blue with white cabinets. I think you can make your vine with pink leaves if you want. It's your vine. Do what you want. But I guess this is another one of those you can draw shows, you know, where people who say they can't draw, they haven't given themselves a chance. Do something simple. Anybody can do this. Scented, yeah, scented Crayolas. They issued some that have scents, and like the licorice, oh my gosh. If that doesn't make you gag, nothing will. For real. I'm bad about scents of any kind. I like my clothes to come out of the dryer smelling good. Like, that doesn't bother me. But artificial scents, and I love the scents of candles. But, yeah, there's just, if they're too florally or whatever, oh my gosh, I can't take it. Like, you guys care, right? But I love the smell of a rose. But artificial rose scent? Oh, God, that'll gag you. Oh, okay. Eileen does not have green walls. She has off-white walls. And all the green. Of course, living in Boca Raton, yeah, she's got green all over outdoors. I'm going to have brown outdoors here pretty quick. It's going to be nothing but brown. My mother had green walls in our house when I grew up. All right. Have you had about enough of this vine yet? this is just to show you. It can be so simple. Alright. I'm going to do pink again because it's my birthday and I get to do it. I just do yellow circles here and there randomly. I've done this for years. I used to do it in high school. On all my books, there were vines everywhere. And maybe I saw it somewhere. Maybe I copied this off someone. Heck, I don't know. I agree, Dorothy. Clothes dried outside. Oh, yum, yum, yum. All right, that's not going to be a dark enough pink, so we'll use the next dark pink. And this one might be too dark. I guess I better... Yeah, see that one? Oh, they don't have a good pink in here. That's all right. We're going to use this one then. I mean, you can do this so fast. You can do an envelope in 10 minutes. I'm sorry I didn't go look at that video you wanted, Lynn. Honestly, I haven't had time. That's been since Friday night. Yeah, that was over the weekend. Nope, no time over the weekend. None. Eileen's having a fit because I'm using pink because it's my birthday. You tell her, CB. I don't know how this is going to work. I'm just going to try it. I don't normally do this with the pencil around them. When I'm done, like with that, I'm usually done. But it's hard for you guys to see that light pink on the stream. And then it's just adding the detail. And I, you know, there again, it's just go, right now it's looking pretty bland. Still pretty, but it's pretty bland. Where is the... There it is. What I would do, that's where we're at. That would look so nice with orange flowers. You know what, Eileen? I'm pretty sure you're going to get over it. If I had a dime for every time I ever said that to my kids, I'd be so rich. I'm pretty sure you're going to get over it. I'm just adding some veins to the leaves quick. I mean, you can't take a lot of time here. You gotta move quick. Mailman's coming. Now you know how I do my Happy Meal. 10 minutes before the mailman's here, I'm scrambling, getting something out. I think this afternoon for my happiest birthday, I am going to get out my Midori and draw. and watch something on Netflix, because that's what I want to do. I did start watching The Crown on Netflix. One of my friends said, if you like Downton Abbey, you will like The Crown. So I started watching it, and I have to say, I'm enjoying it. I would not even say loosely based. I'd say it's very much based on Queen Elizabeth's life, from prior to her father's death. And right now I'm at her coronation, or just past her coronation. Okay, that little bit of detail in the leaves. I think you missed a flower, or the pink flowers and wilting. Whatever, get over your bad self. Now I'll just draw some little tendrils going out. But you could just sit here and add detail like this the rest of the afternoon if you wanted. Add more flowers. Here, I'll get the dark pink. I'll get the dark red. Just add some little dots. I could add some buds. I could add a bead flying around it. I mean, really, your imagination is pretty much the limit. You can tell I had nothing planned, huh? Other than showing you those books. I did fix the wilted flower. So there you go. And if you got an envelope, you binged on The Crown, Judy. I'm not done yet, but this afternoon when I get out my Midori and start drawing and doodling and playing, I might go ahead and finish it. I don't remember how many I've got left, but that just right there can make an envelope really, really pretty. And add more pink flowers. Yeah, whatever you want. Your imagination, just go to town. I am the boss of my birthday, huh, Julie? You know what? I am such a brat. I am the boss of everything every day. That's pretty much the way I've arranged my life, and that's the way I'm going to live my life. And if you don't like that, chances are we're not going to get along. And when I call myself a princess, I am so not kidding. Because I paid my dues. I raised those kids. Thanks, you guys. They say it's pretty. I like that. I use that a lot. I put it in my journals. Yeah, just whatever. It's very nice. So those are kind of my original doodle arts that I enjoy doing. Poldark. Poldark. I'll write that down so when I want to binge watch, I have something to watch. Pol Dark on Amazon Prime. Oh, and after my stream the other night, Friday night when we streamed, I went ahead and got on Amazon and I found some more Stonehenge paper, pretty reasonable. Was 32 sheets for I think $16, which that's not bad. Josie, I think you're responding to my statement that in my life I'm a princess. Yeah, I think you can demand that if you want to. She's 41 and daddy still calls her baby. Well, actually, my dad just died. I was 59 and my dad still called me baby. So maybe you know where I get it from now. Yeah. So what else do I want to show you guys? tell me something you want to see, because it's 2 o'clock. We've got 1 hour until Gene comes on. Oh, I thought of another. I guess I could do it now. Another flower that I draw. I'll just draw myself a grid real quick here with. Well, I guess I could use green to make Gene happy. I don't know. I like blue. I'm just a blue girl. All right, Eileen, do not get me even started. Because it's my birthday, you know, I could actually drink that. Eileen is just wanting to get me going. She is. The girl is a terror. She is a terror, I'm telling you. Terrorist. Someday I'll do the tool show that Carrie asked for. I bet she's napping today. And I don't need a big grid. You'll get the idea from just a small grid. Now this one I do want more squares, and they're not even, and I'm not going to worry about it. But you get the idea of grid. You could do this on graph paper or draw your own. If you get yourself that T-square, drawing yourself grids is not hard at all. Remember, the edge of your paper is always going to be straight because it's a milled edge. Go for it, Janet. You want to see me do that shot? I don't want to be asleep at 5 o'clock. Which was what would happen if I did that. This I almost, well, I'll just use these pencils because I have them here. They're these pens. Because I have a lot of pens. A lot. Oh, Carrie was going out this afternoon. Well, I hope she's having fun. She can watch the recording later. Okay, what I do is every other box. And this can be as big, or you can do it like a border. I'll do that many of them. I'll do orange. I like peach colored, but that's all right. Is Dee Dee still here? She's probably going, what in the world is wrong with you? Do some art, girl. But all I do is I put a yellow dot in the center, and then I made orange flowers. This is going to be a Bronco design. Broncos won yesterday, but boy, I'm not sure about that last call. They maybe shouldn't have won. Okay. And then take a green, and you can do this with anything. Colored pencil, whatever. I'm just doing it with this. Whatever I've got nearby. But this on an envelope looks real pretty too. Or on a card, or in your journal. I decorate in my journal a lot. Just a real quick little tiny flowers. Yeah, CB said learning tangles and doodles teaches you a lot of patterns you can use for borders. Exactly. Okay, and then I'm going to switch to colored pencil now. And I'll color in. Every other little box, like this. And you can make this as perfect as you want it to be. I'm doing this just quick because I know you guys are fighting sleep right now. I'm pretty sure. Sniff, sniff, sniff. I'm sorry, you guys. I know that's got to be annoying. I didn't even know I did that so much until I streamed and then watched one of them. It was like, golly, girl, go blow your nose. Okay, can you see that? Hold it up again. Just a pretty little design. And then I'll just take, this is a darker blue. And you can do any color combination. I just happen to like blue. And I kind of color in the orange, or the corners. It's just another way to add another color. And I think every color you add makes it just a little bit more detailed, more interesting, prettier, whatever. Did anybody watch the Bronco game yesterday? I'm a huge Broncos fan. I don't get very many of the games, and I quit paying for the NFL package because I didn't use it. So I don't get to see all of them. I have to catch reruns or whatever. But I'm glad they won. They're my team. And you know the thing I'm just so happy about? My dad was a huge Denver Bronco fan. He was one of the original season ticket holders when they built Mile High Stadium. Mile High Stadium isn't around anymore. They've torn it down and put up some other name field. But he was an original ticket holder. And when we were kids, we got to go to the games. And of course, they've been in multiple Super Bowls. But my dad was sick last year at Super Bowl time. And the Denver Broncos went to the Super Bowl. And so my brother and I flew up to Montana to spend Super Bowl Sunday with Dad, and they won. And honestly, I hate to pray for like the outcome of a football game because I think that's ridiculous. But honestly, if I could have asked for anything in my life, it would be that the last Super Bowl my dad ever got to watch would have been the Denver Broncos winning, and it was. And I'll always have that. Now I'm going to probably cry, but I'm so glad that they won, my dad got to see it, and I got to be there. And my dad's birthday is day after tomorrow, so I may be getting sad for that all alone. That this is the first birthday I won't have him. So here you go, Bronco border. So there you go. There, it finally focused. So anyway, just stuff like that. Here's my product for the last 2 hours of my birthday. It is, Grammy. It's special memories, and I'll never watch another Super Bowl or really another Bronco game and not think about, the Broncos winning the last Super Bowl. Woohoo! First are hard, but Gene, believe me, I have been through a lot of death and a lot of firsts. And I do okay. I do. I think it's been really hard with my dad. Because your parents are somebody who has been with you your whole life, you know? I mean, it's like, it's hard. But anyway, I love my dad. I'm glad he's in heaven. I know he's watching. And tomorrow he'll eat a piece of cake for me because we always had birthday cake on the day between our birthdays. We always shared our birthdays. Yeah, you're 17 years into it. I'm, let's see, 15 years into mom. The anniversary of her death was October 27th. So I just had that a couple weeks ago. But I don't live for those anniversaries. I really don't. In fact, I didn't even think about it until the day after, and I was like, oh, good, I didn't set myself up for sadness, because I don't want to be sad, and I don't think they want me to be sad. So I'm glad I had them when they were alive, and now they've moved on, and I'll see them in heaven someday. So, all right, let me think. I'm thinking, I'm thinking, I'm thinking, I'm thinking. Help me think. Okay, I'm gonna yank this out. I just pulled down some of my artwork. This is a cool flower that you guys could draw really, really simple too. For real. I'll show you real quick. I don't know. Right, I hid my circle template from myself, you guys. Today's a bad day if I don't find it. I can't live without it. There we go, I found it. Oh, that's so cute. Jean, that your dad would be a Walmart greeter in heaven. I don't know what my dad would be in heaven. He would be, I don't know. That's it. I might have to think about that. Patting on the table probably felt good in your ears, didn't it? Sorry. Sorry, Charlie. All right, the center of your flower. Let's see how much paper we got. You'd think I have a shortage of paper in this house. Shortage of paper and pens. Not hardly. Right, now what I'm going to do. All right, I'm just going to do this. Because if you want it uniform, all of your petals should be about the same size. They're not that way in real life, but for my purposes, they're going to be. Okay, I gave myself kind of a little guideline there. Now I'm going to draw petals. Simple stuff. I guess this was a doodle flower day. I could do this all day long, though. I really could. That's a simple enough design, right? You can't have enough paper or pens, believe me. If you saw. Oh, geez. Oh. I have plenty for everybody. I'm not sure how I justify buying more, honestly. But what's coming tomorrow? Pens. What's coming Wednesday? Paper. It's all right. I deserve it. But my feeling is, how do I know if I'm gonna like them unless I own them and try them? Somebody has to do that. And I'm glad to volunteer. Okay, so that was the second step where I just added the second layer. And look how uneven they are. I mean, this is not perfect, boys and girls. It's not perfect at all. But by the time I get color on it, who's gonna notice that? And that's the thing, don't give up when you think, oh, that one isn't the same as the one next to it. Nobody's going to notice. Who cares? And flowers aren't like that in real life anyway. Now, if I was being more careful, things like that where I went over that line, that would annoy me just because it's hard to get rid of later, and I don't like to have to go back and clean up a bunch of mess just because I'm careless. There you go. You know what, Eileen? I was telling Robert before we went live. I told him that I had ordered some stuff, but it's not going to be delivered till tomorrow, and we're not going to be here. And I said, the UPS guy is going to come in, and he knows to... I have a breezeway outside my front door. It's like an indoor-outdoor room. And he knows that he can come in there and just drop stuff off. But I said, I'm not going to be here. I said, I'm going to miss the hunky UPS guy. And Robert said, you think he's hunky? And I said, well, I mean, yeah, he's better than average. I said, but I've got all the ladies on stream thinking that I'm in love with the hunky UPS driver. But he is really a nice guy. And even Robert loves him. I mean, and when it's hot in the summer, I always offer him some lemonade or, you know. Because he's in and out of that truck. He's working hard. I'm nice to him. And he's nice back. So, and we always have the same one because, of course, we're a rural route. And so after they get a driver who knows the route, I'm sure they try and hang on to him because with the lake out here, roads don't go through. So you have to know where you're going. And you're going to drive around for half the day trying to find a particular house, and you might have to drive 5 miles out of your way because of the darn lake is in the way. So the fact that he's trained and knows the area, I'm sure that's valuable to UPS because it's saving them a bunch of time. But he is really a nice guy, and he is definitely better than average for sure. He's got nice legs, I'll give him that. And the reason I've seen his legs is because he wears shorts. Jeez, I know what she's going to say. Oh, my UPS guy will chat. He doesn't just drop. I mean, a lot of days he does. A lot of days I don't even see him, but yeah. But keep in mind, if they stand and chat with you, that makes their day longer because they have got to deliver every package on their truck for delivery that day. So that's why you'll see them out late in the day delivering, because they have to deliver every package on their truck. Yeah, see, I know. When he shows up here sometimes, he is hot and sweaty. I can tell that poor guy is about ready to die. I have to get out another color UPS, another color pencil. Okay, I won't do another pink flower because I don't want Eileen to cry, because she is such a crybaby. She doesn't mind telling me about it. I think maybe, what color? Do we want purple? We haven't used purple. We'll use purple. My favorite colors. I'm not really a purple fan, but whatever. Oh, your Amazon orders come post office. Your mailman's a jerk. My mailman is a girl. And I've got her trained right. So... yeah, see, they either get to go home early or they have to stay late, CB. That's why my daughter-in-law was a UPS driver up in the mountains in Colorado. Talk about a hard route. OMG. But anyway, she was a brute. And I say was because she's not my daughter-in-law anymore. But anyway, Yeah, so I learned a lot about UPS and what they do with their drivers. Okay, there's our flower before we add color. Just a basic old flower. Anybody could do that. That is simple stuff, boys and girls. I don't know why, if it's the child in me or whatever, because I know not all centers of flowers are yellow. But if I'm left to my own devices, the center of my flower will always be yellow. What is that about? That's my inner child coming out, huh? My inner child comes out way too much. That's why I say I act like a 12-year-old boy, because I laugh at stupid stuff or I say stupid stuff. Have a warped sense of humor. Yeah. But when you raise five boys, that's pretty much where you get stuck. You act like them. CB has a hunky mailman. See, you just got to pay attention to your delivery, people. All right, I'm going to. Here's how we're going to color the flower. Real quick. Give it a base coat of a medium. Well, this is maybe the medium and the light. I could go back and add light later. Next time I do a flower show, we'll do a more realistic step out, okay? Today, I guess, is just doodle flower day. I hope we're good company, Dee Dee, because you sure aren't learning nothing. I'm just getting some color down here. All I'm doing. Try not to go outside the lines, but if I do, I'll worry about that later. Like Dee Dee says, there's nothing you can't fix. I just don't like to have to go back and fix stuff that because I'm careless and stupid. Five boys. Oh my God, you need a medal. Yeah, well, I have three boys left. But yeah, we had five boys and one girl, and I promise you, I'd rather have 10 boys than one girl. I have a theory that adolescent girls are crazy. I mean crazy. So I would take 10 boys, because boys are too stupid to be dishonest, you know, like with a boy. You get what you see. They just put it out there. It may not be pretty, but they put it out there. You know what you're dealing with. Where girls, oh my God, they're so emotional and drama, drama, drama. Boys aren't like that. They're just out there. So I didn't mind the boys. I liked the boys. I also had five brothers, so maybe that's why I don't have a problem dealing with boys, because I've been around them a whole lot. All right, I just got a little bit of color. See? Carrie said the same thing. The boys are so much easier than the girls. And they were. Except me, I was a good girl. But, yeah. I would much rather have, you know what I'm going to do? Dee Dee never does this, but I'm going to do it just because I'm going to move the color. You know, I could have done that with water-soluble product, but I didn't. I did it with regular Prismacolor. Um... I'm going to go ahead and move that color with some odorless mineral spirits and turn this place flammable. Why not? I like flammable. What'd Max say? The latest, he managed to squirrel a wax crayon into the washing machine. Oh no! That's funny, Mac. Her, one of her kids got a green crayon in the washing machine, and all the clothes came out green. I didn't have that. But we had plenty of other stuff, believe me. With five boys, you're always dealing with something. Oh, I guess. Okay, this is my odorless mineral spirits, and I have it in a little tiny jar with a sponge so that I don't have to stick my thing. I just put my Q-tip up against the sponge, and it'll transfer it to here. Yeah, I don't remember where I learned that from. It was someplace on YouTube, but it was awesome. Now I'm just going to move the pigment around with the mineral spirits, and it's going to make it real, real light. And you can do this with, what is it, Eileen, Gamsol, whatever. 220, honey, is Sue over there yet? Huh. You looked? Did you look?
Yes.
Okay. Well, we need to keep our eyes out because it's really, they've got to be close.
Are you still streaming?
Yes.
Okay.
Say hi to the ladies. Be a gentleman.
Hi, ladies.
There you go. That's Robert Vaughn saying hi to the ladies. Yeah, they should be here really any time.
Okay.
Make sure you know where that mail is. I don't know why I'm not going over there, and I'm nervous. I'm nervous for you, honey.
Oh, well.
Oh, well. It'll be all right. I hope she's calmed down. Everybody's saying, hey, Robert, you're such a loser. Oh, wait a minute. They didn't say that, Robert. I must have said that. You guys, I do that to him all the time. Don't think I'm being mean when I'm on the phone with one of my siblings and they say, well, say hi to Robert. I always tell him, well, Rock said you're a big fat loser. So he's, believe me, he's got a hard shell. He's put up with me for a long, long time. So he knows. All right, here's what it looks like after I spread the colored pencil. Lynn says I'm mean.
You're hollering at me?
Yeah, because I said, the ladies are saying, hi, Robert, you're such a loser. Now they're ready to kick my ass. They're saying I'm mean. Yeah.
Here they said that and they hurt my feelings.
No, they say I'm being mean.
Oh.
Being mean to you by calling you a big fat loser.
Yeah.
But you're used to it, so you'll get over it. Anyway, all right, we're going to add some violet. This is quick and dirty, quick and dirty. I don't have much time left. Jean, are you getting ready for your stream? Are you ready to for all of us to come over and invade your house? And I'm teasing Robert. He's used to that, okay? So don't go around thinking I'm mean. I'm not. That boy's got it better than anybody I know. He gets to live with a princess. He just doesn't know how lucky he is. All right, I'm adding the dark where I'm going to want shadows. Alright, Jean's still awake and she's working on having all of us come over there and invade her house soon. So that's cool. Jean, I asked you earlier what you were going to do on stream, and then I guess I never thought to look up and see your answer. You're full of yourself today. Lynn, I pretty much am like this all the time, but don't take me seriously. I pretty much know and accept that I'm full of crap. I do stuff just for the laughs. I think life is short and you ought to be laughing most of the time, so I don't take myself even a little bit seriously. Really, life is too short. Have fun. No reason not to. But I can have a serious side too. But most of the time, I'm pretty much all about having fun and the laughs. People who get crotchety as they get older, I think those are the people who forgot how to laugh. And I have no intentions of doing that. I'm going through life laughing. And I'm using the mineral spirits again just because I am. I don't do this often. I really don't. But I wanted it to be pretty quick, so that's why I pulled this out. Because I could take as much time as I wanted. You know, you've seen Dee Dee when she's doing her colored pencils. I mean, you can honestly take as much time as you want making this thing look realistic. And this is pretty quick. I just want to give some depth where there, I think there should be depth, because keep in mind, I'm not using a reference. This is right out of my pea-sized brain. You know what I wish I had for my birthday? Cheesecake! What made me think of cheesecake? OMG. Was I totally off camera, you guys? I'm sorry. You laugh a lot around. CB, I think if you want to be the queen of everything, you just give yourself the title and act accordingly. So that's what I did. I just gave myself the title princess, and I go around to acting accordingly. And who's man enough to argue with that? Right? It does, Josie. Life is a lot smoother, and You can deal with a lot of difficult situations if you have a sense of humor. For real. You can diffuse a lot of bad stuff with a good sense of humor. So anyway, now I could just keep dinking and dinking and dinking and moving that. And pretty rough, but I could smooth it out. I mean, honestly, I could just sit here. And this is a coarse enough design that I could fussy cut this out and glue it on something. And if there are places I don't like, just keep moving the pigment around. As long as you got the mineral spirits, it'll just keep moving and moving and moving. It's kind of like the water-soluble products. Yeah, I see. I could just, you are, Eileen, you are serious all the time. Thanks, Lynn. You're sharing with Janice. You're going to share the queen title? Oh, I think in your own life, Shell, send me the cheesecake UPS. But I think in your own life, we can have multiple queens. Yeah. In your life, if you're the queen, it's all good. So you don't have to share it if you don't want. Be the queen. Now I'm just thinking. Thanks, Grammy. Serious, Eileen. Judy, I have heard that petroleum jelly works the same, but I don't know that firsthand. Oh, well, hang on. I've got some right here. Unwad those panties, Eileen. Exactly. Since we're experimenting, I'm going to get some. We're going to see. The thing is, though, like with the odorless mineral spirits, it evaporates. So when it goes away, you have no residue left. And there's no odor. Yeah, there's no odor. There's nothing when I'm done with that. All I've done is dissolve the binder, the wax, with the mineral spirits. But here I've got some petroleum jelly, and just because we can, we will give it a try. But I think there's going to be, see, this is left from the other night. We'll just use it because we can. I'll use the Copenhagen blue. I love that shade of blue. I think there'll be residue left, but we'll just grab some petroleum jelly out of here. Honestly, this petroleum jelly, I don't know if it has an expiration date, but I may have had this like 20 years. I think it stays good. Oh my God, Lynn, you are killing me, girl. But I'm thinking, okay, it definitely moved the pigment. You are seeing this firsthand. Yeah, no, I would say the mineral spirits definitely is better, and I'll tell you why. I just got a little dab, okay? I didn't get much at all on here. And I'll never be able to get rid of that. And I don't know if you can see that big booger there. Can I get the light so that you can see it? Anyway, that's excess petroleum jelly. And you can see exactly where I had my original lines. So I would say, yes, it works. It does release the binder. That releases the pigment from the binder, for sure. But look at now, I got it everywhere. I'll be having blue petroleum jelly. I wish I wasn't on recording. I'll be having blue petroleum jelly on hairy body parts. So there you go. I mean, now I've spread it out pretty much. Let's see if I take this. See it? Now I got to throw that away or it's going to be everywhere. So there you go. And the mineral spirits doesn't do that. Is the Q-tip you are using flat? Yes, it is. I'm going to go ahead and see if I can pick up the rest of the petroleum jelly, you know, so there isn't any residue. And that much came off on the napkin, and that's what I'm left with. So that's how petroleum jelly works. Say it, Janet, I dare you. I almost did, Eileen, but you know me. Don't even dare me. Oh, see? Now I'm going to go crazy. All right, I'll show you these swabs. These are Swissburs, dual-tipped, 100% cotton applicators, not Q-tips, cotton swabs. It's not an ear scraper. You shouldn't put these things in your ears. It's dangerous. This is what they're like. Well, against the white background, it's hard to see. Let me get something where, yeah, there you can see it a little better. One end has this point, and they're wrapped pretty tight. They're pretty densely wrapped. And then this is pressed flat. So, my friend brought them to me the other day. I've had these before. She got them at Walmart, but to use in art, not to put in your ears. If you have stuff in your ears, go to the doctor. Don't put stuff in your ears or up your nose. That's my public service announcement for today. And don't put petroleum jelly on body parts. Except a sore baby bottom. I won't be able to put this on YouTube now because you guys have drugged me down in the gutter with you. Oh well, I'll just put up with the rude comments. I don't care. And that woman who told you you can't sing, Jean, I don't know who said that, but they need to go get a life. I would have answered back and said, oh, you obviously listen to rap. They call rap music? Are you kidding me? Anyway, that was my rant, and I'm over it. All right, and it's 25 minutes till Jean's. You guys, I'm not sure that I taught you a darn thing. Maybe I entertained you for a couple hours. I know there's people laughing in the chat right now, so we did accomplish a giggle or two. Anyway, so there is some flowers that you can draw. What else? What else? What else? And then remember the easy doodle type. Those are easy. Here, I'll do a color. Oh, what it, there they are. Okay, Jean. I said that exactly, Juju. Anybody who says Jean can't sing listens to Smashing Pumpkins or something that they don't even have a clue. People amaze me. They never, ever, ever cease to amaze me. I did use pink. I did use pink. Okay. This is just that rose, you know, that when I was doing those doodles earlier. I don't know where I did what I did with him now. Jeez, I can lose stuff faster than anybody I know. Okay, this flower. That was before Lynn came. I do that a lot with color, too. Hey, Eileen. Pretty. I'm using it. When it gets on the yellow, it turns more orange. But there you go. That's about as simple a flower as you can get. So, start simple, work on more hard stuff later. Just, you know, I guess if I was going to say anything is just don't be so hard on yourself and don't have unrealistic expectations about what you can do, but start somewhere. Even if you start with a curly Q flower like this, and that's what I'm drawing for you, is even if you draw something like this that's so simple, anybody can draw a curly Q flower. Anybody can do that. So start somewhere and give yourself credit as you go. We're not all going to be Dee Dee because we didn't start 50 years ago. But I'm going to be happy with where I'm at. Give it a little bit more depth. You know, I mean, there's certain aspects of this that are going to be true, whether it's this simple curly Q flower or whether it's the most elaborate botanical drawing. The more detail, the more time you take, the better your end product. But there's nothing wrong with quick and dirty easy either. I could just keep adding more detail now and add other flowers next to it. See, that's another thing is, you know, you might look at that and say, okay, fine, I'm done. But I don't want to be done yet. I want more flowers. So I'll pick another kind to draw next to it. We'll draw, what kind of flower do we want next to it? We'll draw more of a square shape. But this is more just like playing, and I would say just play. You don't always have to have a finished product. You can just have flowers for flowers' sake. And this, I've never seen a flower like this anywhere, anytime. But when it's next to that little yellow flower, it's going to be pretty. But now that you guys have bought all these products, use them. That's why one of the reasons I like my, when I talk about my journal all the time, I'm talking a lot of times about my bullet journal. Just keep adding stuff, because if you did that whole page of flowers, it's going to be gorgeous no matter what. But that's why I like my journal, is because I don't have to do a finished piece of art every time I sit down. I can just sit down and doodle some flowers. Black and white color I get to use if I haven't used my nail colors in a while. I can get them out and play with them, or my markers, or yeah, like that's why I like my journal a lot. So anyway, we got 15 minutes till Jean. So what else do you guys want? Thank you, Juju. All right, and the only other thing I would say is if you guys have suggestions of what you want to see in the future, let me know, because I'll try and put together a show or get the books out. Believe me, if there's a book written about it, chances are I have it. Whether it's lettering or animals or I don't know. I mean, I have books about everything. Kind of like Dee Dee, but anyway. Yeah, send me suggestions, and if there's something you want to learn about products or drawing, I will never be able to teach you about art journaling. Go to Angie's stream, Paula's stream. There are other girls out there, Jean, who do art journaling far better than I ever could. I'm a novice there. It would make me nervous to do that. But if it's about drawing and stuff like that, I enjoy it. Thanks, Iffy. I'm going to have a great day. Thank you, Petka. So, thanks, Shells. I'll look forward to the cheesecake in the mail. Actually, I do want cheesecake, but I don't know where I'd get it around here for sure. I have coffee ice cream, and that's just as good. So, thank you, Kingor. You guys are so nice. Thank you, Vicky. I hope it was a fun stream for you guys. Thank you, CB. Oh, who else would I want to spend my birthday with? I like you guys. Thanks, Judy. Mac. Thank you, Lynn. I'm going to enjoy my day. I'm getting ready to close this bad boy up so I can get over to Jean's. I think I'm going to grab something to eat real quick. I'm kind of hungry. Not cheesecake, obviously. I don't have any. But I will be at Jean's. Yeah, tomorrow's going to be a fun shopping day. I'm going to buy food. Yay me. So, there's streams tomorrow. I'll miss them. Thanks, you guys. I'll be yakking at you a little while over at Jean's house. I so appreciate you coming. Thank you if you've watched this on Ustream. If you haven't subscribed, you could. I have like 10 now. So, anyway. Thanks so much, you guys. You've been the best. I'll see you around the interwebs. Later.